Star Wars 9.
Good morning, everyone. We're starting our new Star Wars adventure today, as you probably have noticed.
When Kathy Kennedy called and said, would you work on episode 9, literally one of the first things that crossed my mind was that I would get to work with John again. Like, literally, it was one of the things I thought, oh my God, I cannot not do this.
So we're going to play now the first piece then. 1976, when I was 12. Okay. And it sounds like this. We play Star Wars and you know this.
Getting to watch him conduct, hearing the music that he's written, being part of at all his remarkable body of work, was just an opportunity I could not possibly say no to.
To go back to the beginning, the first day we did Star Wars was the first day that a trumpeter called Morris Murphy had been admitted as a member to the London Symphony Orchestra. So the first service he did was Star Wars recording number 1, and he came into the stage and blew that top C, which sort of blew the world's head off.
I've had the good fortune of working with John for most of my career. He's been actively involved in all the Star Wars movies, and he consistently finds these incredible themes. And you sit there saying, how in the world does he do this?
Hey! Listen to me! Chewie!
This is marvelous. This is very touching here, I think. I need you to protect her and all that. I love that.
I don't like to read scripts. Reading anything, we form our own sort of vision of what things look like. I'd rather look at a film and be surprised at what's happening and remember those moments that are revelatory.
I love you.
I know.
What are you going to say? Yeah. I love you too,
Violin.
The process for me is if I have to go to the piano and start to work. I can't do it thinking about it or walking around the room or walking in the trees. I have to go to the piano, start to write something that isn't very good, look at it the next day or a week later and try to make it better.
I will take scene by scene. I will write a few bars and then go look at what I've done on the screen and rework it.
He writes, and then he goes to the piano every once in a while and makes sure that he's still in the same key, and he comes back and he writes some more. Great composers all wrote that way.
He still writes by hand. He doesn't compose on a computer. I mean, technology can change the picture, but John's thematics, it's the same brilliance as it was for the first one.
It's hard to believe that it's been 40 years since we began this.
This is a unique opportunity where a composer can keep working on the same body of work and continue to add to it. What a privilege is that?
Play one of them. Up, down, up. One, two. What if it's just reversed?
One of the challenges has been, should it be so new that it doesn't fit the body? Can you play Rey's theme alongside of Leia's theme and have them be the same part of the family, even though I'm 40 years older? So far, they all seem to want to live together. With Rey writing a theme for her, she was little more than the child in number 7. Her metamorphosis, if you like, from 7 to 9, she's an adult now. She's become a magnificent woman. I can treat it in the orchestra so that it's in a more grown-up way. So you will hear it, but it's not quite as simply presented. The changes of Rey, they are part and parcel and in tandem with the changes of Adam Driver's character to something heroic. I could turn Ren's theme around not upside down, but reharmonize it, which is actually JJ's idea. He said to me, well, can you make the trip from Ren to Ben on the same theme?
It's the same theme, exactly. It's extremely different.
No, but however you do it, but an idea of the, you know, trying his hardest now to be the best he can be, as opposed to he's trying his hardest to be as bad as he can be, which is the only thing he's been doing.
Can you change the theme or turn it upside down or something? And I think I initially said, well, no, I've never done that, and how do you do it? But it worked out where his evil theme morphs brilliantly into a kind of a hero theme by a change of harmonic support and so on. The Emperor's theme, which was a little motif, really, meaning a sort of short theme, the presentations of it in this film are more numerous. It always made me smile a little bit. I don't know. It's supposed to be very nasty. I think it's very powerful, these challenges of force against force that our heroes bring up against the all-powerful one.
I am all the Sith.
I was just mistaken for Steven Spielberg at the gate.
Seriously.
Do you have an ID? And I said, I left it at home. I said, any chance you recognize me? He said, oh, you're Steven Spielberg. I wish I'd said yes. I missed that opportunity. It came this close.
How many scenes have we scored with this guy in it?
Yoda lifts it in The Empire Strikes Back. Romero Bellegarde, the music editor, he said, oh, it should be exactly the music that we had for Yoda. And actually, JJ questioned it. He said, well, should we be doing that right? And everybody said, oh, yes, it has to be. It's, you know, the fans will all know. So we went back to the score of Empire Strikes Back to get those bars exactly out of them. That actual little central piece of taking the ship up is exactly as we had it before. It's an exception, the use of something literal from an earlier film. Revisiting specific themes, you know, I'm happy to do it. It's great to see these characters revisited here. Brings us to Carrie, of course. We see her in the film, and we hear her theme referred to. And I feel very good about it. It's nice that she's still with us anyway and part of it. I just think the last couple of words of the film are so completely magical. We have to have 40 years of preparation for that to get the full feeling of what that means. I felt so satisfied and so complete in a way.
Who are you?
I'm Ray.
9 episodes in a great tale, beautifully done over many, many years. And that means that it's not an ending. It is here with us and it will stay there and makes our lives part of that story.
Rey Skywalker.
Mm-hmm. The last day of recording on films like this is always a little bit emotional. There's a sense of satisfaction coming to the end of the musical journey of it. But there's also a little sense of feeling sorry that we won't be meeting again next week to record some more Star Wars music. I would be quite happy to have it go on indefinitely.
I feel like we've been together for a very, very long time. I really will miss seeing you. I wish we had more to play, but I cannot thank you enough for this opportunity to be with you. Bravo, thank you for your artistry and for your obvious love of music. Thanks so much.